Landing a jet on an aircraft carrier is one of the most dangerous tasks in aviation. The runway moves, the space is limited, and there's no room for mistakes. Despite rigorous training and cutting-edge technology, accidents still happen. And when they do, they often happen in front of cameras. In this video, we'll take a look at five of the most shocking aircraft carrier crashes ever caught on film, and what they can teach us about the hidden risks of naval aviation. On March 18, 2011, a routine carrier landing aboard the USS John C. Stennis turned into a dangerous incident in a matter of seconds. An F-18 Hornet approached the flight deck, preparing to catch one of the arresting cables, designed to bring the jet to a stop within just a few meters. These cables, also called arresting wires, are made from steel and are engineered to absorb enormous forces, up to 50,000 pounds of tension, as jets land on the short flight deck. But during this landing, the cable snapped. The F-18 skidded down the deck, while the loose end of the wire recoiled violently across the flight deck. Several sailors on deck were injured by the recoiling cable. The pilot managed to eject and survived. Fortunately, there were no fatalities. But the incident grounded flight operations and triggered a full investigation. The investigation pointed to equipment fatigue, a reminder that even in the highly controlled environment of a carrier deck, mechanical systems can fail. And when they do, the margin for error is almost non-existent. In November 2021, the British Royal Navy was conducting operations in the Mediterranean Sea, on board the HMS Queen Elizabeth, one of the newest and most advanced aircraft carriers in the world. A squadron of F-35B Lightning II stealth fighters was preparing for takeoff. But one of those takeoffs didn't go as planned. Shortly after leaving the deck, an F-35B lost thrust and crashed into the sea. The pilot ejected and was recovered safely, but the nearly $100 million aircraft sank to the bottom of the Mediterranean. At first, speculation pointed to technical malfunction or pilot error, but the investigation revealed something far more trivial and far more frustrating. A simple rain cover, designed to protect the engine's intake while the jet is parked on deck, had been accidentally left inside. It was never removed before takeoff. The foreign object obstructed airflow into the engine, leading to a sudden loss of power. The incident was a stark reminder that even the most sophisticated military equipment is vulnerable to simple human mistakes. In aviation, small oversights can have enormous consequences, no matter how advanced the aircraft. Carrier operations at night are among the most challenging tasks for naval aviators. Limited visibility, rough sea conditions, and high operational tempo increase the risk of accidents significantly. In March 1998, aboard the USS Nimitz, that risk turned into tragedy. An EA-6B Prowler, a twin-engine electronic warfare aircraft, was returning to the carrier after a mission. During its landing attempt, the aircraft failed to properly engage the arresting wire. It struck the flight deck at an awkward angle, flipped over, and erupted into flames. Despite the efforts of the deck crew and emergency response teams, all four crew members on board the aircraft were killed. The incident highlighted several long-standing challenges in carrier aviation. The difficulty of night landings, the danger of deck operations, and the limited margin for error, especially with older or more complex aircraft like the Prowler. It also reinforced the importance of constant training, strict maintenance, and clear communication between flight crews and deck personnel, all of which remain critical to reducing the risks in carrier aviation. The F-14 Tomcat, an icon of naval aviation, known for its sweeping wings and long-range interception capabilities, the Tomcat dominated the skies for decades, but even the most advanced fighter jets faced danger. Not just in combat, but during day-to-day operations. On September 14, 1976, aboard the aircraft carrier USS John F. Kennedy, a seemingly routine day on deck turned into a costly accident. an F-14 Tomcat, during taxi operations, was blown off the flight deck, reportedly due to jet exhaust from another aircraft. With no time to react, the Tomcat slid off the edge and plunged into the North Atlantic Ocean. Fortunately, both the pilot and the radar intercept officer ejected safely and were quickly rescued by recovery teams. But the aircraft itself sank to the ocean floor. The US Navy later conducted a recovery operation, raising the sunken F-14 from the seabed. Their primary concern? Preventing the advanced Phoenix missile system and classified avionics from potentially falling into Soviet hands during the height of the Cold War. The incident served as a stark reminder that life aboard an aircraft carrier is as dangerous as it is demanding. Whether in the air or on deck, precision, coordination, and constant vigilance are the only things standing between routine operations and disaster. The deadliest accident in the history of the US Navy's aircraft carrier operations happened not during combat, but during routine flight preparations. On July 29, 1967, the USS Forestall was conducting operations in the Gulf of Tonkin during the Vietnam War. The flight deck was crowded with fully armed and fueled aircraft ready for launch. Suddenly, a Zuni rocket was accidentally fired from one of the parked F-4 Phantom jets. The rocket flew across the deck and struck a parked A-4 Skyhawk, rupturing its fuel tank. What followed was a catastrophic chain reaction. Jet fuel ignited, triggering multiple explosions. Bombs, some of them decades old, detonated under intense heat. The fire raged for hours. By the time it was finally contained, 134 sailors were dead, and over 160 were injured. More than 20 aircraft were destroyed. The USS Forestall disaster led to sweeping changes in how aircraft carriers operate. Firefighting equipment was improved, ammunition handling protocols were revised, and safety training for all personnel became mandatory and far more rigorous. This tragedy revealed the inherent dangers of operating large numbers of high-performance aircraft in such a confined, volatile space. It also reshaped carrier safety standards for generations to come.